Hello, you lovely people. We're gonna make beautiful, crispy, juicy, tasty, perfect crackling. You're either a lover or a hater, but if you love them, my lord, people go mad for them. Crispy, savory, salty, explosive little mouthfuls of joy, which I'm gonna give you some simple tips to guarantee you the best cracklings every single time. And often cracklings are a byproduct of roasting a joint of meat, but not today. We're gonna do dedicated crackling. So let me show you a foolproof way to do it. First thing that's very important is get yourself some good skin from a lovely free-range pig. It does make a difference in the flavor for everyday cracklings. About a centimeter of fat is perfect. Any less than that, it's gonna go dry and leathery. Any more than that, and it might just be a little bit kind of wobbly. We don't want that either. You see, this bit's a little fatter than this. So we'll get a knife, just like that. You can get your butcher to do this for you. And if you get that little bit of fat like that, you can just slice that up, and that will render in this tray and melt away and just help everything fry up beautifully. So secondly, slicing. So we want to slice this crackling about a centimeter thick. So lay your skin out fat side down, and that way it's going to render much quicker. There's little gaps in between, and then get a second tray, this is the first tip, and put it on top and press it down, right? It will just stop it kind of bending up too soon. So this goes in an oven at full whack. So this is 250 degrees Celsius, which is 500 Fahrenheit for 10 minutes, and then I'll show you what to do next. Right, time for a little clean down. So, you can hear it frying, it's had 10 minutes. The reason for that tray was to weigh down that fatty side to render that fat quick. Now, we close that oven door, right? It's sizzling in there, and what we want to happen is this kind of sort of souffleing, like puffing, like popcorn. So 10 minutes, maybe 15 minutes, but it's a perfect time to make some flavored salt. Now, flavored salt is the next level. It's a brilliant thing. So let's do this. A little bit of chili, fennel seeds. Just take a little bit of lemon zest. One little nick makes all the difference. Have a nice little bash up. It already smells amazing, but get it as fine as you like. And that is the potential for amazing seasoning. We're gonna get our salt, muddle it up. Can you see it changing color? And then we would shake this on a tray, just leave it overnight. The humidity from the citrus, it would go. Then we can smash it up, put it in a jar, and it's good for months. So there is our little seasoning. And if we just taste a little bit. Oh, brilliant. Now come and have a look at this. Popping, crackling. That is texture. That is an explosion in your mouth. This is the critical stage. You know, if you forget it, you'll burn it, right? And literally when I do this at home, I just watch it like TV, and my kids think I'm so weird. But when I take the crackling out and I season it up and I put it over there to cool down, every single time I go and do another job, I come back, it's all gone, just crumbs, right? So the kids might mock me and they might mock you, but they're gonna love your cracklings. That's all I can say. This, my friends, is perfect crackling. Look at that. Look how beautiful they are. Just amazing. For all your mates that might have enjoyed crackling down the pub, they have never tried anything as beautiful as this. So it's kind of the magic of taking something that's really not edible and creating it into something that's not just edible, but delicious. I would even say like a glass of champagne and some fresh cracklings. And then last but not least, it's seasoning with the salt. Now, the fat, don't go throwing that down the drain, A, because it will block the drain up, but B, that's good fat there. You know, that's from a healthy, really, really beautiful animal, right? So that fat is gold dust in the world of cooking. That goes on your roast potatoes, or even that and cooking some scampi or some scallops. You know, that is really, really good stuff. So what I love to do is get yourself a little heat-proof glass jar. Let this cool down a little bit. Take a herb like sage or rosemary. Use those herbs to flavor that fat. We can just pour this into our jar very carefully, and that will offer up so much flavor to future cooking. So do not throw that away. Ladies and gentlemen, homemade cracklings. A thing of beauty, very decadent, and a lot of love in there. The question is, do you like it straight or do you like it curly? I think I like it curly. Right. And that's not sound effects. That is proper, true crunchiness. Joyful. Always good. What are you waiting for? Nip out down the butcher's. Buy some skin. Yeah. Let your hair down. Have some fun. Enjoy.